Good evening, morning, whatever time it is, everyone. My name is Jaden, and welcome back to Free City. Today we're going to be talking about Free Guy and a couple things I just like in general. I have this book up here because I wanted to show I got it. It's nice. So today we're going to be talking about Free Guy once again.
I'm not going to be the good guy. I'm gonna be the great guy.
Okay. Well, enjoy your lifetime supply of virginity. Off you go. Sweetie.
So it's directed by Sean Levy and stars Ryan Reynolds and Steve from Stranger Things and Hitler. It's a fun movie. I actually really like it a lot. It's probably one of the best movies that came out this year. It's really competing with what? The Green Knight? The Suicide Squad? Oh, Quiet Place Part 2. Yeah, that's better than A Quiet Place Part 2. I felt like I was being way too nice on that one. I mean, I still give it a 9.5 given that rating. But this one, it's not like... I'm not the biggest fan of forced romance. Yes, this movie is about a hot NPC who simps for Jodie Corner. I don't know who she was in Star Wars. But this movie... Well, it's funny. It reminded me of two things, basically. It reminded me of the Lego movie and... The Truman Show. I don't know why. I mean, the Truman Show parts make sense, but the Lego movie, it just... Yeah. Ryan Reynolds is... He was good. I mean, was hilarious. And I think I liked him in the first half than the last half, but... this is gonna be a spoiler review, screw it. There's one scene where the battle between Ryan Reynolds and who plays this guy called Guy, and then this dude called Dude. He's like this big Hulk type guy. So he pulls out a Captain America shield, and then it cuts to Chris Evans, and then the Hulk then. And then he punches a guy, and then he pulls out a lightsaber. It was probably the most satisfying ending, or final battle, of pretty much any movie I've ever seen. God, I'm a sucker for fan service. It was probably the most satisfying... It was probably the most satisfying final battle I've ever seen. God, I'm a sucker for fan service. But yeah, this movie is super fun, super funny. I love Ryan Reynolds, Yeah, I really want to see Deadpool, but it's just this one, there's just some stuff, this film had incredible pacing, probably on par with Jungle Cruise, which, even though it was not the greatest film, that film's pacing is, I'm not someone who frequently plays video games, but I got all the references. I like the fact that it's about an NPC turned person, which is basically the main plot. Yeah, it's fun. There's not really much to say about it. The music was great. I actually really like it. There's a lot of references to other things. I think there's kind of a reference to The Shining near the end. I don't know. This feels like something that Ryan Reynolds pitched. Because, yeah. It's just... If you want a funny comedy, yeah. I still don't know how this movie got a PG-13 rating, but it's, there's some jokes in there. Guy is hilarious. He's super well written. I think Nostalgia Critic reviewed it. Doug Walker, I don't know. He's reviewed it saying that if this was made, 15 years earlier, it would be with Will Ferrell. Yeah, I can see that. Will Ferrell, Jim Carrey. But I think it'd be funny if Jim Carrey did The Truman Show and then this. If you don't know my rating system, an 8 out of 10 to a 9 out of 10 is a golden ticket. And a trophy is a 9.5 out of 10 to a 10 out of 10. I give Free Guy... an 8 out of 10, a golden ticket. Now let's talk about some things I really like and just a little bullet point list. Let me go grab them. Oh, whatever. So let's start off with stuff I like. wait. Let's start off with books I like. So my favorite book of all time that I've ever read, at least, it's, some stuff has come really close, but this, so far, is The Disaster Artist, The Great, My Life Inside the Room, The Greatest Bass, My Life Inside, The Disaster, My Life Inside the Room, The Greatest Bad Movie of All Time, My Life Inside the Room, The Great, My Life Inside the Room, The Greatest Bad Movie Ever Made by Greg Sestero and Tom Bissell. It is super funny, it's super short, and it's super well written. It's, yeah, it's about 270 pages. It's super, one of the most satisfying, and I like how, the pages, like, it kinda, some of the, here's another one. A series of unfortunate events, and Dolores Claiborne do this too, where it kinda looks like a journal with it being uneven, and I kinda like that. It definitely fits the style of this book. It kind of feels like you're going through this everyday life with him. The movie, not that great of an adaptation, but still a really great film. Yeah, this is my favorite book of all time. I said I wasn't going to review it, but I'm not going to review it completely, so it's going to be kind of a dual review, brief, whatever. So this is going to be a part of the things I like, but I'm, yeah. A quick review, if I ever reread it, which I might, I probably will, I give this book a... Yeah, I screw it. 10 out of 10. First 10 out of 10 on my channel. First 10 out of 10 on my channel. 10 out of 10, screw it. Trophy. Whatever. Now, throw this sucker back in here. Luckily, I made a book report on it, so I still have all my opinions from when I first read it written down. Now, secondly, a part of the books, my favorite Harry Potter books. I actually have two of them, but one of them's better than the other, so I'll show you my second favorite. The Goblet of Fire. I love this one a lot. It's, I like all of it, except for the Yule Ball. It was, that's the part that really just, that's, every Harry Potter book, has that part in the middle that just kills the pacing. And that was the Yule Ball, but pretty much, this book is nearly perfect. It's just, if they cut that, if they shortened that out, or they shortened that, or made it have much more of a significant meaning, then I probably would have liked it more, but they definitely kind of, after that, it wasn't really important until my number one favorite Harry Potter book, Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. So the funny part about this is that this book, after complaining about a pacing killer, this one's pacing killer, it starts off that way. It's such a boring opening. The Other Minister is such a boring chapter. The Unbreakable Vow, it's all fun. See, the thing about this one is that the movie, actually I'll get to the movies after I get through all of this. But yeah, this is my favorite Harry Potter book. Now, my least favorite Harry Potter book is Chamber of Secrets. I'm going to do a Harry Potter ranking, so I'm not going to give all of it away. But this is my favorite Harry Potter book just because I like it. Yeah, it's super well written and really good pacing. But, of course, it actually has more, like, pit stops rather than one chunk that, yeah. So here's some films I like. La La Land. It's, I've seen it once, and I really liked it. I'm not going to give a rating because I want to rewatch it soon. Yeah. My first film that I've seen with Ryan Gosling in it. One of my, like, probably my fourth with Emma Stone in it. The Django Unchained is my favorite Tarantino movie, and nothing you say will change that. Hereditary is one of my favorite horror films of all time. It's the best A24 film. Super good pacing. Yeah. It's quite a bit, but it's really good. Ferris Bueller's Day Off, my favorite comedy of all time. One of them is listed, the one of my other ones in here is listed as a commentary. Okay, comedy. But I do not consider it that. Now, I said Hereditary is one of my favorite horror films of all time. This is my favorite horror film of all time. The Shining, it's just great. I love The Shining. Doctor Sleep was pretty good, too. It's probably my favorite horror sequel. I have it down over there. But, yeah, this is probably one of my favorite horror... It is my favorite horror films. I also like the cover, too. It's actually the first one I ever saw. Cartman! One of my... Birdman! My second favorite movie of all time. And, my favorite, I think, yeah, I can say, this is a drama, this isn't a comedy. I love one-shot films. I saw 1917, and I loved it. This was a one-shot, well, technically, it's kind of a one-shot, even though 1917's two shots, but I'll get to that in my review. But, Birdman, or The Unexpected Virtue of Ignorance, really good film! That's one of the ones where I won't do a spoiler review. You just gotta watch it for yourself. 2001 A Space Odyssey. Watch it. It might seem boring to some, weird to others. Well, I mean, it is Stanley Kubrick, but it's so good. So I have two favorite TV shows. One of them I don't have because it's on Netflix, and one of them I do have because they actually took it off Netflix. So one of my favorite shows is BoJack Horseman. It's super funny, entertaining, dramatic. I really liked multiple plot lines about it, and it's like, it's just so fun. Well, not fun, it's definitely not fun, but it's super just interesting, creative, and some of the stuff, it's a very acquired taste. Only some people will like it. But it's still definitely, it's a perfect show, except for the first season. But yeah, BoJack Horseman, super fun, super entertaining. Now my second favorite show, The Office. It is my favorite sitcom of all time. I don't consider, BoJack Horseman's more of a comedy drama. I'm considering rewatching it, but I don't have a lot of time. Yeah, my favorite character is Creed Bratton. It's just a super engaging sitcom. I really like the mockumentary style. Michael Scott is amazing. My favorite season is either season 3, season 5. What? My favorite seasons are either season 3, season 5, and season 7. I love the threat level midnight thing. Yeah. So The Office is my favorite show. Now let's talk about, let's go back to Harry Potter a little bit because I like talking about Harry Potter. It's really fun. Harry Potter, my favorite films. I got the set from Target. Shoot. That's my biggest problem with the set. So my favorite Harry Potter film is Deathly Hallows Part 2. I put it above the movie. So my favorite Harry Potter film is Deathly Hallows Part 2. I put it above the book because I made a half an hour video talking about why my problems with the book. But yeah, it's just super fun, super fast paced, and it's just bam, 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 bam. Except for Gringotts. The Gringotts in the book sucked. My least favorite film is, once again, Chamber of Secrets. I don't like the Half-Blood Prince. I can't tell if I like it or not. Because when I go into it, I don't like it. And then I come out with a different opinion every time. And the Goblet of Fire, though, it's good if it didn't have the source material. If it wasn't based off a book, it would be one of the greatest. Okay, not one of the greatest. It'd be a pretty good film, though. Sorcerer's Stone, Morn, everyone's looking through it, including me, through rose-colored glasses. On HBO Max, some deleted scenes were definitely in there. Like, I remember the choir scene. But yeah, when all these films were on HBO Max, I remember the choir scene right before Dumbledore's death. I remember the scene with Snape and Karkaroff in The Goblet of Fire. I don't know about deleted scenes been the other two. But yeah, they put some deleted scenes in there. I don't know. But yeah, these were a few of my favorite things. When the dog, okay, I give up. Where's my lens? Thank you guys so much for watching. That was my review for Free Guy and just stuff I like. Stay golden, everyone.